When first time I came, you became very joyous. And when you decided that I am the real messenger of Rama. But now, I gave you a great information. Like, you know, Ravana was killed and Lanka became ours now. And then you became speechless. Then she said, no, no, Hanuman. When you brought that news, I had something to give you. But now this news you gave is so valuable. And there's nothing that I can repay it. So I just became speechless because I cannot repay anything to you. Oh, it's not like that, Mom. Just give me a chance so that I ask what I want from you. Okay, so that you can satisfy me. Okay, yes, go ahead. Give me 5 minutes time. What do? I crush all these Rakshasis who are sitting around you since 10 months, causing a lot of pain to you. So give me just 5 minutes time. I show everything what they showed you during 10 months. And then she said, no, I don't allow that at all. You can't do that. They did their job, that's okay. They're appointed for that and they did the job. Why should you punish them? After all, they paid for that. So you cannot. She stopped him. You know, she was able to stop a monkey, you know, from his misdeeds. So, and God is, you know, far closer to her. And because when she said, bring that deer to me, he simply went, that's all. Knowing that it is not right, knowing that it is impossible, still when she said, he did it. Whatever she says, no questions are asked there. He did it, that's all it is. And when that is the case, when he is such a kind of person, and she is able to convince Hanuman, don't you then think that she can definitely convince even the Lord himself? Lord also? To save us. And when she says, I want these souls should be saved, if she says, finish, it is done. That's why she can really do it. And Hanuman is the right example for us. What they said in Sanskrit is Kim Punar Nyayam. Kim Punar Nyayam means, you know, when one is able to eat away a house, one is able to eat away a house, do you think, you know, an apple is a hurdle for him? Huh? That is called Kim Punar Nyayam. When bigger things are able to be done, then what about the smaller things? This is, you know, than kyanter than in English? It's a peanut.
No, it's a cake.
Yes, it's very simple for him. It's not a difficult task for him at all. That's what the sutra says. And then, all this is about Sri. You understand? So far the description went on and on and on like that to talk about the Sri. And he is Man. The Man in Sanskrit is called as Matup. Matup is a suffix to the word Sri. And when that suffix is added, like Matup, a suffix came and joined, it became Sri Man, like that. So what this Matup says? Yuruvar Setyum Nityam. That means both together is not came yesterday. They did not come together yesterday. And they are not going to be divided tomorrow also. That is Nityam. Their being one or being together is eternal. They are always together. Today they are together. Yesterday they were together. Tomorrow also, they will be together. So they cannot be separated. There won't be any separation between both of them. This is what the Sri Man Narayana. That means the Narayana with the Sri is always there. Sometimes you may be able to see, you may not be able to see sometimes. That's all it is. It's up to your perception, but not the difference between them. She's a jivatma. She's a jivatma, but among the jivas, she falls in the category of nityasuris. Jivas are in three categories, right? One category of jivas are always with him. They never become subject to this karmic bondage. So they are called nityatmas. And we are called baddhatmas because we are pretty much subject to the karmic bondage and we are just lying here, you know, going up and down and up and down like that. And some souls, they are subjected to karmic bondage but got rid of this karmic bondage and reached him are called muktatmas. Baddhatmas, muktatmas and nityatmas. Among the nityatmas, the first and primary place given to Mahalakshmi. That means she is also one among us only souls. Why? So that she can understand our fate and intercede on our behalf. No? She knows everything about us. So she is a soul from among the souls. That is what we have to understand, okay? Here they go to the extent and say, Ivalode kudiye vastuvinudaya unmai. The very existence of Lord can be proved only through her. Without her, his existence also becomes vague. Understand? The example is sun. How do you understand the existence of the sun? Through the light. If there is no light, still can you say that, oh, there is sun. No. Without rays, no sun. And without the fire, without the burning ability, if you say that is fire, it makes no sense. But of course, without fragrance, there will be flowers. Nowadays, you know, but they need not be called as the real flowers. They are only flowers for decoration purpose, not really for any good purpose. So we don't consider the flower without a fragrance. Vasana leni puvu, panikiradu, you know, it's useless. So with her presence, his existence becomes fruitful. What is the purpose of God? Tell me ultimately. What is the purpose of God's existence? To save us. To receive our services. And it is the mother's presence that makes him to receive our services. That means that's very pivotal. Because of her, everything is done by him. For her sake, he does everything. To please her, he does everything. That means you can understand how important she is. This is what he says. That's the reason. Why she is always with him like that? Why does she, you know, with him continuously, all the 24 hours? What do you say? 24 into 7 into 365, like that, you know. Why she is like that? Two reasons. Ishvara Swatantratayam Chetananude Aparadhatayam Kandu Agalamattal. She will not move at all away from him because he is always Swatantra, independent one. He need not obey anybody. You know, he need not bend his head before anybody. That is pretty independent one. And we are also great in committing sins. So in independence he is great, in sins we are great. So both are great in one sense or the other. Seeing these two, she never tries to go away because we may approach him at any moment. during midnight we may have that intention to approach Him, or during the midday we may have that approach, the intention to surrender, or evening we may get that intention to surrender, or early morning we may get the intention to surrender. Whenever we have that intention, and if He says, no, this is not a time, you know, come when she is there, that means, again, the next moment we may have that idea or not, who knows. A person who is interested in donating something, you know, yes, he wanted to give $1 for some good cause, take it immediately. Take it immediately. And don't tell him, hey, you know, there is counter, go and give it there. By the moment he reaches, his mind may change. You may not feel like giving. And don't say, oh, I have no receipt book with me, so when I keep it, just you come back. Then he may not come back at all. Whenever the idea comes, it should be done immediately. So whenever you surrender, He should accept you immediately. That means she must be there always with Him. Then only she can say anything on her behalf. Because we are pretty much, you know, drowned in sins. And then He is so independent, and He can say, I will punish you. He should not say that, and should not go back. Seeing these two things, she is always with Him. You know? So, ultimately, it is trying to say, the Pedalokacharya Swami is trying to say us a message, a convey a message, saying, Chetananakku ivai irandum ninaithu anja venda. You need not feel any kind of fear by thinking of these two. What are these two? His independence and your sinfulness. You know, some people, I am really sinful, how can I approach God? Let me go. Don't think. He is so great and He is very, very independent. He may punish me. You need not, you know, get any kind of fear like that. So by seeing these two, you need not at all have any fear. That means you can always approach, no matter when it is, and no matter who you are, you can still approach. It gives us a sort of confidence, so that, you know, we are always fit to surrender, to approach them, right? They are giving the example, because ival sannidhiyale kaakam talaippettad, because mother's presence is there with him, so the kakasura survived. Adu illamayale, because mother's recommendation was not there with Ravana, mudindan, he died.
Then we, of course, mother, we should also have God in our heart, right? Without her husband's...
He is always there with you. Do you think that any time...
Suppose I don't surrender to him, I don't want him, but I still go over and say, hey, forgive me of my
sins
with your husband, would she do it?
She convinces you in a way you surrender to him.
That's why, you know, like, Prahlada, the father, and Ravananda, because they didn't surrender to him.
No, she, Sita, tried her best to convince Ravana, though Ravana was not at all interested in surrendering to Rama. She had every effort, she made every effort to tell the greatness of Rama to him, to convince him to surrender. But when every effort was failed, then with a kind of pain in heart, Rama killed him. Even Rama, when he approached Rama also, twice he left him, just go, see my greatness and just realize and come tomorrow, surrender. Even for that also he was not convinced. Then with heavy heart, Rama killed him, you know, finally. That's why Rama had no vengeance towards Ravana. That's what we need to understand. Same thing. Hiranyakashipu also, he was not having any vengeance, but he was hating the act activities done by him, that's all. It is only hatred towards the actions, not towards the person.